Once we arrived, the place was dominated by a heavy silence. There was sound coming from the kitchen. A kitchen knife rhythmically hit the cutting board as Kaori-san prepared the food. Tai-san was seated away from everyone, desperately yet fluently chanting a sutra. Combined with the kitchen sound, it had a mind-numbing effect. Everyone else was simply falling into a torpor, staring silently into space. Even I, the sanest person in the room, wanted to simply let my mind shut and stop and wanted to simply let my mind shut down and stop thinking. That wouldn't stop me from trying though.
Okay, rather than trying to evaluate the details, I decided to return to square one and summarize the current situation. Takumi-san was dead. That left me, Chiemi, the two Oribes, Kiyonosuke-shi, Tae Amawaki-shi, Meiko, Rikako Uematsu, and Haru Makishima, a total of 9. And Rikako Uematsu, I didn't want to say she became a Yomebito or something, but it was clear that she was in a condition that left her functionally useless. Normally, the right thing to do here would be to take her to a hospital. But instead, they were going to discuss killing her. I probably have to remind them of the sound course of action. Whatever the case, if you ignored Rikako Uematsu and I, only 7 people were participating in the feast. With Takumi-san's death, we would never know what the snake found out about Haru Makishima. Therefore, the only confirmed people were Kiyonosuke-shi, a human, and Meiko, a monkey. And personally, I thought I could trust Chiemi, so that made 3 that left 4 others. This was bad. I wondered if Chiemi understood that. I had to talk to her in private. We kept Meiko away from all that happened this morning, so she was still in the dark about Rikako-san.
お姉さんはちょっと具合が悪いんだ。静かにしといてあげて。
ねえ、お外行っていい？
危険じゃないかね。
私見とくよ。すぐそこなら危なくもないでしょう。
The two left.
安永、ちょっと。
何かな？
ちょっと、取ってきてほしいものがね。
She looks sus.
手洗いを借りる。
More and more people left. They probably didn't feel comfortable standing up until now. Tae-san just continued chanting though. It was like she lived in another world. Beside her, all that was left was her. Haru-chan. The way she constantly shifted in her seat made it clear she felt uncomfortable.
Takumi-san のことは残念だったね。
I tried talking to her.
Hey.知恵姉もずっと頼ってたし。
上松理香子さんは？
私、あの人苦手よ。気味悪いもの。
知恵美ちゃんは平気そうだったけど。
知恵姉は強いもん。
彼女、上松さんがこっちへ来たのっていつ頃のこと？
2年か3年前。だいぶ前よ。
That seemed like plenty of time to get to know a person, if you ask me. Or maybe not. Yasumizu's people had been suffering at the hands of the village heads for generations. Of course, they couldn't just accept her.
彼女は長者だというが、植松家というのは一体どういう家なんだ？
何が聞きたいのよ。よそ者はおとなしくしてろって言われるの何度目ですか？
ああ、ごめん。これは無神経だった。じゃあ別の話にしよう。それはいい？
別にいいけど。
I looked around and I saw Yasunaga-kun walk upstairs. I lowered my voice and asked,
君にとってモッチーはどんな存在だったんだ？
なんで聞くの？
お葬式代わりだよ。
え？
お葬式では亡くなった人のことを話すだろう。死者の思い出を話すことは霊魂の供養になるらしいよ。
なんか意外。
何が？
もっと 血も涙もない人だと思ってたから、供養とかそんなの言い出すって思わなかった。
That was just rude.
モッチーは野里の子だったけど、選ぶった感じじゃ全然なかった。すっごく変だったし、知恵姉と同じくらいいろんな問題を起こしてたけど、人を傷つけることはしなかったし、みんなはモッチーのこと頭おかしいって言ってたけど、私はそうは思わない。とっても面白い人、多分テレビとかに出て大活躍するようなのが向いてたと思うわ。一つ上だったけど、ほとんど同い年の友達みたいに接してくれたし、楽しかったわよ、すごく。兄ちゃんもすごく仲良かったし。
そんなに？
うん、いつも一緒にいたし、学校でもヒーローみたいな二人組だったよ。時々横にいて寂しくなるくらい仲良かった。
Her visage dimmed. I felt like she was easier to understand than most. If Mochi had really liked her, it must have been a tough love. She hadn't even looked at him in that regard, and being with Yasunaga-kun even made him a target of her jealousy.
でも彼はもういない。安永君は辛いだろうな。
うん、
彼を手伝ってあげたら。
安永君 was going up upstairs. Again, I gestured at him with my chin.
え？
なんかお手伝い中っぽいし、千恵美ちゃんは外だし。君はモッチーの代わりにはなれないかもしれないし、そこに立つべきは千恵美ちゃんなのかもしれないが、最後に決めるのは彼らだとして、それまでにしてあげたいことを我慢する必要はないんじゃないか。助けになりたいとは思うんだろ。
うん、あなたも。
まあ彼女には一宿一飯以上の恩があるからね。下心がないとは言わないが、それ以上に彼女を支えたい。彼女は僕には見えないものに随分苦しんでいるみたいだから。
やっぱりあなたのこと誤解してたかも。
仕方ないよ。行くのかい？
うん、昨日のこと謝らなきゃだし。
じゃあ僕も外へ。
We stood up at the same time. Though Haru-chan was always on edge, deep inside she was a really honest girl. I worried that she'd fall victim to some scumbag like me down the road.
あ、
何？
やっぱりあなたは逃げた方が。いや、何でもない。
ん？ She cut herself short and hurried upstairs. Apparently I'd gained some of her trust, but it didn't look like I could get anything more useful than that bit of advice. Unlike the other inhabitants, she just believed that escape was possible. That was why she tried to do it yesterday. That might have been the extent of it.
それで誰が怪しいと思う？
ハルちゃんと安永くん。
I walked up to Chiemi, who was looking after Meiko, and we started a conversation.
ハルちゃんはともかく、安くんなの？
容疑者は実質4人。タエさんと香織さん、そしてその2人だ。このうち、昨日モッチーらが死んだ時に外出していたのは彼一人。さらに狼の狡猾さを考えれば彼以外に考えづらい。
ずる賢いってこと？
うん。
そうなの？
今日なぜ匠さんは死んだ？
え、なぜって狼に殺されたから。
それを聞きたいんじゃない。
え、一体何が。あ、もしかしてこういうこと？雲に守られなかったから。
正解。おそらくもう雲は死んでる。
え、ちょ、
蛇である匠さんは普通に考えれば初日確かに雲に守られたはずだ。そして2日目である昨日、雲が別の誰かを守るべきだという話は 一度も出なかったんだよね。
うん。
ということは雲は引き続き重要度の高い匠さんを守ったと考えるべきだ。雲が生きてたら。
それはそうか。
宴開始後にやられた匠さん以外の人は肝臓さん、吉継君、モッチ、狼ジジイ氏、この4人の中に雲がいて、なおかつそれを狼は見抜き殺して、その上で匠さんを始末した。
How the wolf realize that they killed the spider? Did they know?
そうとしか考えられない。
え、それは考えすぎじゃない？4人も死んだからそろそろ雲もいないだろうってことかも。
楽天的に考えればそうだね。しかし相手が本当に賢いやつだったら、その油断が最後の致命傷になる。
でもどうやって雲を見抜けるって。
うん、いや、
声が大きい。
うん、
なんでもないよ、メイコちゃん。
え、
She resumed scribbling on the ground. She was completely absorbed in it for some reason.
雲についてはもしかしたら見抜けた可能性があったかもしれない。
それってどうやって？
初日、肝臓さんが安永君に喋らせてから最終決定をさせたって言ってただろ。僕の見立てでは彼はもっと率先して動くタイプだし、初日は誰も殺さないという判断を下しそうにもない。
まあそう言われたらそうかも。
彼が喋って決定が行われれば、場に与える影響はとてつもなく大きい。そしておそらく決断はある程度正しい。だから狼に狙われやすい、こう僕らは考えたよね。
そうだけど、同じ時にヤス君も狙われやすいって話したじゃん。
逆を返せば、自分が狼なら狼に狙われるリスクはないわけだ。それよりも大事なことを黙っていて不自然がられる方が危ない。だから当たり障りのない情報は出す。もしそうならとても賢い選択だ。そうは思わない？
でも肝臓じいちゃんがそんなに喋らなかったって話とどうつながるの？
これから言うのは完全に憶測だけど、肝臓さんが動かなかったのは権威を発揮して狼に目をつけられるのを防ぐため。なぜその必要があったか、彼が自身の生存が全員の生存にとって必要だと判断したから。なぜなら
まさかカゴ持ちだったから。
そうだ、それもおそらく雲。
どうしてそこまで言えるの？
雲は正体がバレた時のリスクが最も大きいカゴだ。なぜなら自分を守れないからね。それでいて正体がバレない限り、狼に対して一夜分無駄にさせられる可能性がある。だから彼は極力目立たないように振る舞おうとした。しかしそれが逆に狼の注意を引いたんだ。あの人が黙ってるなんてよほどの加護を持っているに違いないとね。それで狼は彼をまんまと初日に仕留めることに成功し、丸裸になった匠さんを翌日に片付けた。
憶測だってのは分かってるけど、なんとなくそうだって気もする。
もしそこまで敵が意図的だったとすると、現状起きている異常事態も狼のショートカット戦術と考えた方がいい。
どういうこと？
ルール外で人が死にすぎている。吉継君、モッチ、狼ジジイ氏、そしてほぼ死人扱いの上松理香子。狼にとっては予定外の死人が出ることは歓迎すべき。宴の回数が減ればくくられる危険が減るから。だから意図的に人が死ぬように仕向けているとしたら。
話はわかるけど、どうやって？
吉継君については、例えば夜に出歩くように仕向けて汚れに追いやった。モッチーと狼ジジイ氏については動機まではわからないが、上松理香子に 彼らを殺させたとすれば辻褄が合う。
ん？
え？
What？
大さんは植松家の役割に絡めて汚れの原因を語っていたが、もっと筋の通った説がある。植松理香子が二人を殺したとすれば、一日一人しか殺せない宴のルールに抵触し、汚れの対象となるんだ。
I put aside the idea that there were apparently two types of corruption, slaughter and madness.
でもそんなの無理でしょ。彼女あんな服着てるんだよ。着替える暇なんてないじゃん。それに男二人相手に彼女が挑んで勝てるわけないってば。
じゃあこういうのは、モッチーと狼ジジイ氏、どちらかがどちらかを殺し、残った方を彼女が殺した。二人目の血を流したことで、彼女は汚れの対象になる。服についてはわからないが、何か割烹着でも羽織ればいけるかもしれない。検証するまで不可能とは言えない。
それはでも一人だって相手は男で、
片方は何歳かもわからない老人だしな。あるいは殺し合って互いに弱ってたかも。
殺っ、そんな、なんでそんなこと考えられるの？
だから全部憶測だ。動機だって不明。しかし話の筋は通っている。
じゃあそれがどうして狼の陰謀につながるっていうの？
動機の話になるとわからないけど、弱みを握ったとか、殺すように仕向ける方法はあるんじゃないかな。あるいは彼女自身が狼だとかね。
Jimmy was at loss of for words. I had no choice but to continue myself.
狼の他の仲間が優位になるように自ら時計の針を進めたって可能性もある。
それはないよ。狼は数が減るほど不利じゃん。
確かに狼対人の人数比で言えば、一人対二人はうまい交換じゃない。しかし誰もがその打算を働かせられるとは限らない。誰もが合理的に動くわけじゃない。非合理的なことは多分起こってるし、その全てを予測することは不可能だ。
いや、聞きたくない。
でも諦めるわけにはいかないだろう。
もう何も考えたくないよ。
ごめん、いろいろ言ってさ。
ううん、こっちこそごめん。でもちょっときつい。
僕もこれ以上君たちがこんなものに付き合う必要はないと思う。脱出するなら協力するけど。
無理だよ、分かってるんだ。ここに生まれたならここで死ぬしかないんだよ。
そんなのは単なる思い込みだよ。
神様が見えない人にはわからないよ。
ああ、わからないな。困ったな。
困ったな。If this was some tabletop fun for the whole family game, I'd have already punched the GM and left. But lives were actually on the line here. Not just my own, but also that of someone I kinda like. We made it thus far, yet she was uncooperative.Maybe I was going about this wrong? Maybe if I wanted to save her life, I had to start by saving her from the darkness within. Or maybe from the unidentified supernatural phenomenon that was binding her. Though that didn't seem like something that could be done in just 3 or 4 days. Still, I'd struggle until the very end. I couldn't participate in the feast myself.So I had no choice but to leave it to Chiemi. I didn't say anything more to her. I just chose to believe she'd overcome her inner conflict soon. Meanwhile, Meiko's drawing had grown so large it felt like she would get lost in the mist.
Oi!
I left Chiemi and went to Meiko.
Me!
She waved at me. Good thing she was kinda used to me now.
さっきから何を描いてるんだい？
こっちがね、お守り。
お守り?
One drawing showed a warped circle with a line just as strange going through it. but I could see what it was. It looked much like the Higuchi family crest I saw in the dining hall. There were four of them apparently. The others were hard to differentiate. On the whirling drawing was the same as the one on the stone. The symbol of the Yomotsu Okami.
なるほど。新内さんのお守りか。お姉ちゃんに教わったのかい？
うん。
こっちのは？お守りじゃないね。
家畜。
I certainly wasn't expecting to hear such a vivid words from a girl about 4 years old.
動物かい？
うん、これがね、牛。
ふむふむ。
これはロバ。
おお。
こっちはね、豚。
ああ。
The ground wasn't the best canvas, and the little girl wasn't the best artist. All I could really tell was that they all had 4 legs.
これは？
私。Oh, it had 4 legs though. Well, whatever.
じゃあ、一番でっかいこれは？
狼。
A light chill went down my spine.
え、なんで狼なの？
狼が来るから。
What? That was like.
狼が来るから逃げて。逃げなきゃいけなくて。
待ってくれ、メコちゃん。君は狼を知ってるのか？
会ったことない。でも怖いって。
それはここの狼？
ね？
蛇とか猿とかは？
知らない。
狼は何をするの？
家畜を食べる。
食べる？
うん。お馬は食べられたって。
Apparently, this has nothing to do with Fujiyoshi's legend. I had no idea if this was from a picture book or her imagination, but there were barely any links between the stories. Or maybe I was rushing to conclusions.
そのお話は誰に聞いたの？
本当だよ。
じゃあどこで会ったことかな？
遠く。
遠くか。
ずっと歩いてきたの。
Well, it didn't like look. Well, it didn't look like I could get any details from her. If far away referred to the land of myth, and I actually had truths regarding Fujiyoshi's legend that weren't told here. What the hell was I thinking? Land of myth? How stupid! I should just calm down and file it under more info that made no sense to me.
そっか。頑張ったね。
お腹すいた。
そうだね。僕もだ。
うん。
As we turned around, I saw Chiemi stand up in the mist again and hesitantly beckon us.
食事ができたそうだ。
Kiyonosuke-shi was standing at the entrance to the dining hall, wearing a gloomy expression. He was never particularly vigorous, but now his visage was haggard, and he wasn't nearly as arrogant as before.I couldn't blame him. The only person he was friendly, flirtatious, flirtatious to, Rikako Uematsu, was in an awful state. Also, despite all he said, he actually relied on Takumi-san. They seemed to be close in terms of age too. And from what I heard, he never really said anything wrong. The only problem was his insensitive choice of words. The feast was a communication game.Even if you were right about something, it didn't matter much if you couldn't convince anyone.
ありがとうございます。
Still, he was the one. Well, still, he was one of the mere two confirmed humans. Treating him badly and making him upset wouldn't help at all. I had to be courteous.
行こうか。
Courteous.
うん。お腹減ったね、メイコちゃん。
Jamie had calmed down a bit. I already told her my suspicions.I now had to hope she handled the feast well. All that was left now was get some nutrients to support my hard-working brain, right?
すみませんね。こんなのしかできなくて。
She ladled what appeared to be rice gruel from the large pot. It was a thick white soup with vegetable, rice, and something brown inside.
シシリだ。慣れてます？
ええ。生のはダメになっちゃったから。
ちえみちゃん、
I whispered to her.
どうしようか。
春秋さんはどうしたい？
We were talking about the thing where I had to avoid the local food.
せっかくだから今回は貫こうか。
OK。ありがとう。
What did I mean by this time? Did I think I had another life or something? It was fine. It wasn't like I was cool with dying just on the off chance I got a second shot. Dying wasn't an acceptable option. I wasn't about to compromise on that.
ほっつき歩いても仕方ないし、ここで待ってるよ。
わかった。
召し上がらないの？
結構アレルギーあるんで。
若い人は変色しよるからいろいろ食べんと強くなれんわよ。
Hey, I was lying. But telling actual allergy sufferers that they should just eat and that be cured was actual murder. Well, there was some effort to cure allergies by carefully injecting the allergen via vaccine, but that was a subject for the doctor. Anyway, going back to the dorm by myself was dangerous since they suspect me. So I just waited in the corner of the room, still hungry.
安永君と春ちゃんは？
まだ上かな？
いいから、熱いうちに。
もっとついで。
僕は彼らを呼びに行ってくるよ。
I went up the stairs and when I reached the second floor, I stopped for a moment. I heard some rustling. Was it possible they'd gotten that intimate in just a few minutes? Was I about to ruin the mood? Well, food was important too, I said, to get their attention and slowly went up, making sure I was loud enough for them to hear me coming.
食事だそうだよ。おや、安永君。あ、どうも。
The room was full of stuffs. It was a huge mess.
なんか探してるみたいだけど、まだ見つからないの？
ええ、新しい割烹着が屋根裏にあるって言われたんですけど、見つけられなくて、他もひっくり返してたところですよ。
そうか。
見た？
え？
その、よければみんなには黙っててもらえますか？
いや、その、勝手に気を使いはしたけど、別に何か危ないシーンを目撃したわけじゃないんだけど。お楽しみ中だった？
何言うのよ。
嘘だよ。こんな時にそんなこと君たちはしないでしょ。
そりゃそうですよね。
もちろんよ。
Really now? I was still kind of worried.
じゃあ一旦切り上げて食事にしたらどうかな。
They didn't argue. So as we prepared to go backThere was a loud noise from downstairs.
何?
Yasunaga-kun and I looked at each other, then ran out of the room without saying a word. We were met with a strange scene. I instantly realized what had happened and who was responsible. Kiyo no Sukeshi was wearing a furious expression, his shoulders shaking. There was a shattered plate of rice gruel at his feet. The contents were still steaming.He was facing Kaori Oribe-san, who was standing completely still. Did he throw his food to the floor? Was it that bad? No way, this was clearly something way bigger than that.
いきなりどうしたんです？
Chiemi and the others didn't seem to understand either. They shifted uneasily.
Uzuda!
なんですと？
Uzuda! Uzu! Shishitake にトリカブトが入っている！
What? What's that?
メイコちゃん、食べた？
ね、いただきます。まだ。
他に誰も食べてない？
ちょっと待って。何が何だか。本当なんですか？
見ろ、この生煮えの傭兵を。光沢があり、裏も白くなく、先端が尖る。匂いも違う。よもぎや二輪草じゃない。
ほんまです。こりゃ、フスじゃ。
山菜を入れたの、母さん。
ええ。
あ、危なかったね。間違えてそんなの入れちゃって中毒が起きるところ。
殺す気だ、この女は。
待ちなさいよ。
ただ間違えただけでしょ。それだけで、そんなひどい。
Haru-chan stopped talking when she realized the suspect was acting strange. Kaori-san was staring right at Kyonosuke-shi, not moving an inch and smiling. She was completely glaring him down. Huh? That response was so delayed, we had no idea what it was for. When Kyonosuke-shi backed away a bit, his expression shifted from rage to fear. What?
Kaori-san.
みんな死んでしまえばいいのよ。
What? As she stood there, wailing madly, she brandished a knife. She was hardly moving quickly, but the sight of the blade had stunned our reflexes. I'd seen some bizarre corpses here. I'd bore witness to what pure malice could do. But still living, blatant malevolence, killing intent, was intense enough to paralyze everyone present. I barely registered the scene unfolding before me. Staggering a bit, the woman passed the counter. The sharp knife was still green with something, likely shavings of aconite. She raised her voice and aimed her poison weapon at the nearest target, Kyonosuke-san.
What should I do?
Let's tackle her, maybe? I didn't know why I moved when I did. I was a man of words, not of impulse. In time of crisis, I was the type to turn tail and run after making some sort of parting threat. I shouldn't have been on good terms with either Kyonosuke-shi or Kaori-san to risk my life for them. Yet when I came to my senses, my body was dancing, charging straight for Kaori-san with my right shoulder. And after a brief struggle, we collapsed. I heard her let out a strained cackle in my ears. I had to change my posture. Unless I pinned her knife hand down, But in the end, it turned out I really wasn't cut out for the job. These runabout thoughts were just delaying the inevitable. When the madly laughing woman embraced me, my thoughts ground to a complete halt.
Wah!
She stabbed me right in the back. Simple as that. To her, it was just another obstacle that had to be removed. I didn't know if the wound itself was fatal, but I could tell that the blade had sunk in incredibly deep, and that it was coated in leaf green poison. It must have been a near instant death. My mind quickly grew hazy, yet my final moments were those of self-reflection. Reckless action really aren't my forte after all. Bad ending number 5.
Hitsuji-san! 助けてくれ。
やっちまったな、大将。こいつはいただけねえ。早速ヒントをくれてやるぜ。今回のバッドエンドと題して、ド素人の無謀な攻撃が呼んだ当然の結末で独死についてだが、妻子春明のやつは別に武道家でもなんでもねえ、ただの
Well, I thought she could do it and he could do it。
武術かじった人間なら武器持ったやつからはまず逃げるっつうぜ。武器の怖さをよく知ってるからだ。都市格闘もののアニメや漫画じゃ軽視されがちだが、現実では武器ってのは素手の何十倍も有利かつ危険なんだ。その場のノリで突っ込めば相応の報いを受ける。まして今回は相手が即死クラスの毒まで併用してると来た。どう考えても逃げるが最上。ただそれがままならねえなら、せめて相手よりリーチの長い武器を探しな。つうわけで当然の結末、同じ場所3のみの9毒殺を止めよで、もう一方の選択肢を選ぶこと。
はい、
よし、今回はここまで。次も元気に死んでこい。 そういう夢だったってわけだ。次はもっとうまくやれ。羊が一匹、羊が二匹。
I had no idea why my body began to move. I grabbed the nearest chair without even thinking about it. It was old, wooden and heavy. Picking it up made me lose my balance for a bit. I pointed its legs at the would-be murderer and dashed forward as fast as I could. A crash, a cry of pain, a scream. Amidst the cacophony, I attempted to keep Kaori-san pinned down. I pressed the edge of the chair against her knife arm. She cried out in pain and the blade clattered to the floor. Chiemi then quickly kicked it away. In hindsight, it all happened in a mere matter of seconds. In fact, tying her up was way harder, what with her foaming at the mouth and struggling. In the end, we bound her limbs and gagged her to silence her bloodthirsty screams. With that done, we had no choice but to face reality.
僕がこれを切り出すのはどうかと思うけど、どうするんです？これは。
Six of us stood in the midst, right outside the dining hall. Kaori-san was locked inside.
ねえ、
オリベさんも読み人になってしもうた。
違う、そんなわけない。母さんはちょっとおかしくなってるだけだ。
Kaori-san、やっぱり無理してたんだね。
当たり前でしょ。母さんが義継をどれだけ大事にしてたか。あいつはバカだし、喧嘩っ早くて手がかかるやつだったけど、いや、だからこそ母さんはあいつを一番大事にしてた。父親に似て無謀だって母さんは何度も言ってたから。母は僕が責任を持って落ち着ける。みんな、どうか今日のことは許し、
宴で決めるべきだ。
待ってください、これは宴とは関係ない個人の暴走です。分けて考えるべきだ。
どうしてそう言える？ご婦人は確かに汚れによって狂気を得たのかもしれん。
野里さん、
霧の中のことは宴で決めるべきだ。でないと汚れるかもしれん。
そうですな。
わかりました、行きましょう。ダメだ、このままだと香織さんが殺されるぞ。やすさせませんよ。久石さん、母を見ていてください。僕はフリーでいいのかい？
No one replied. Apparently it didn't matter anymore.
チエミちゃん
your eyes! She was making the same face she did whenever she talked about God.
やっぱりこうなった。
Strangely enough, there was emotion in her eyes. I could see 90% resignation and 10% fear. Watching me until she finally passed out of sight, she followed the others toward the hall.